Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I create videos on Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over how to create business hours within Salesforce. This is really important for any type of automation that you have, especially on the surface end of Salesforce. So let's talk about having escalation roles within cases in Salesforce. So if you have an escalation role that says if this has not been responded to within 8 hours, let's go ahead and bump this up to the next person, up to the next tier. But let's say you got an email at 5:30 p.m. and you have no one on service at 5:30 p.m. and you wouldn't have them until the next day at 8 a.m. That process would still run unless you had business hours amended to it. So if it's 5:30 p.m., 8 hours from then, which is like 1:30 in the morning, that case would get escalated unless you have business hours. So let's go ahead and jump into setup, and I will show you how to set those up. From here, let's go ahead and go type in business hours, or just business. It'll auto-populate. And I'm going to add new business hours. And I'm going to have this be regular business hours. I misspelled it. Of course I did. I'm going to have this be active and the default. And I'm just going to set this from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day except for Sunday and Saturday. Because we are not open Sundays and Saturdays. So I'm just going to exit that out. I do want this to be 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. I'm going to grab this and I copied it. I'm going to paste it for all the days. One more, and let's go ahead and grab the 8 a.m., paste it for all of these, and this might be different in the summertime. I know some places do summer Fridays, so in the summertime when kids are off school, they have half-day Fridays, and you'd be able to also set that up there. I'm going to click save, and now we have our business hours set, and it has become the default rather than the quote-unquote default, which is the 24 hours. You can also add holidays here. So let's say we're going to create a new holiday, have the holiday name be 4th of July. We are going to be closed on the 4th of July. This is a US-based holiday. If you're in Canada, it would be the 1st. This is going to be a recurring holiday every year on July 4th. No end date because this is a recurring holiday. So click save. All right, I'm going to click save again. Will it take me there? Yeah. All right, selected holidays are going to add that. It's been added. And I'm going to go back to business hours and go to regular business hours. And it should see, I did duplicate it, but regardless, 4th of July has now been set. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a like. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below, and I'll get back to you as fast as possible. Like, subscribe, all those things, check out my courses down below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.